Well, hello there, brother, otherwise known as Terry Storch. Wow, there's going to be a lot of feedback. I know I'm going to get text messages and possibly comments from those that know both of us, that if they close their eyes, they can't tell the difference of the way we talk and all of that. But it's really good to see you. Glad to see you in the backyard.
Man, thanks for having me. This I've been looking forward to doing this with you, man. So, and I look forward to hearing that feedback as well. I don't have as raspy a voice, so that's, if people are listening for that, that might be the delineation. And so,
yeah, that's right. So that's maybe the one thing for sure. So Tara, we're as we've talked and as you've seen, I mean, I'm having conversations with leaders. This is a crazy time of the pandemic and COVID, and for those that don't know what you do, what your leadership position is, because it's amazing, and you know how proud I am of you, of the work that you're doing, but help people understand, you know, what it is that you do and how are you guys doing?
Yeah, so I have the amazing privilege of being one of the leaders at a church based in Oklahoma called Life Church. Many may have read about lifechurch.tv. That would be the ministry that I've been a part of now for nearly 14 years. A large, growing, multi-site church, 35 locations, lots of different states. And so how are we doing? Man, we've been impacted in a lot of ways. My role specifically that I'll probably stay focused on, because there's lots of areas that have been, you know, been touched by this, but I get to lead all of the digital and innovation areas of the church. And so how am I doing and how my team's doing? The reality, man, is we have never been busier. This, if you just think of a complete shift from a church standpoint, where digital's been a huge part of what we do as a ministry for a really long time. But that was the caveat, right? It's been a part of. Right now, it is what we do. And so every team that I have the privilege of leading is the church. And so, all of what we do from Church Online, which is so brand new for so many churches, we started doing that 14 years ago. This coming Easter is our 15th year doing it. So we've been doing this a really long time. The Bible app, YouVersion, I helped start that, you know, now it feels like an eternity ago, but in 2008, when that started, never been, you know, we've never seen the growth that we're seeing now. So how are we doing? Man, we're scrambling because of how everything has shifted online and digital.
I've had a couple of conversations, and they're public now. One with a non-denominational church, and then another with the parish, St. Anne Parish, where I go. And you know, the big shift to for any business or for any church that has to go from a face-to-face connectivity piece to, hey, you can't do that anymore, and now we got to stream it. I've heard some stats, you and I've talked a little bit about, you have a platform that basically a lot of churches are, I mean, thank goodness that it's there, but part of what you're so busy and your staff is that this platform is getting overwhelmed in a good way. Yeah. So what are you seeing of how churches are adapting, and what, you know, what's that platform that they're using? Because there's a lot of churches. I mean, the governor of Oklahoma gave you guys shout outs for the amazing work that you guys are doing. So help others kind of grasp how this pandemic has affected you that way.
Yeah. So thanks for doing it. So yes, we as a church have Church Online, and that is Life Church's version of that. But then we also have this whole other team that is completely focused on resourcing and helping other churches accomplish their missions. And one piece of software that we launched a decade plus ago is called the Church Online Platform. And so it's a free tool that we make available to churches all over the world that want to do church online. And so that is one of the areas that we are just seeing astronomical growth. I mean, literally weeks ago, We would see a couple thousand active churches every week and weekend, and that was really good. And to give you context, in the last 2.5 weeks, we have seen just about 23,000 new churches sign up for free accounts. And so our growth rate, it looks like a Facebook growth rate, of sorts, a different scale, but just this radical up and to the right. And so we're scrambling to meet those needs. And what's super interesting, Todd, is a lot of those needs are less about technology and they're more about ministry. It's like, how do you do this online ministry thing? And those are the conversations we love having and helping churches understand what that looks like. Because what pulled us into church online and what we talk our way, there are so many different ways to do it. I don't know there's a right or wrong way to do it, but our way to think about church online is community around content. We don't call church online our podcasts. We don't call church online our, where we give our streams away and we do all of that. People can consume content. For us, what makes it church online is when we bring community to it. So that's what we help other churches recognize, is that it's the community side around content of where the beauty begins and where people can start engaging with one another and feeling like a congregation online. And that's where we're just seeing explosive growth. And the results are just fascinating. And so literally in the last 3 weeks, we've seen on the platform, which is what we call it, we have these opportunities for people to like indicate that they're there or indicate that they gave their life to Christ and made a decision along those lines. In the last 3 weeks, we've seen 128,786 indications of people saying, I'm giving my life to Christ.
Wow, that's amazing. Could you be more specific though?
numbers are important. We track and look at
that's everything. Amazing. That really is absolutely amazing. As a leader, you and I talk a lot about this as leaders. You've got teams all over the place, but I mean, you do have a place of work that you would get into a car to and go to, and you'd have teams that were there. Yeah. That's not happening now. Anything that you would share to help others understand, how to lead through that, what community might look like in a pure remote environment? Anything you've learned or failed at that would help others?
Failed would be a great place to start. So this is not my normal work environment, my backyard. It might feel great for a while, but I do crave community and I crave being around others. I'm a very extroverted leader. Managing by walking around is a philosophy that I really like to employ, and I like to be around others. And so this has been really hard. And so some areas that I've failed is trying to fill that void the wrong way. And what I mean by that is over engaging in places that might not necessarily need me, in those times, because it makes me feel better, and I want to fill this void that I might have, and kind of jumping in. And so I failed in that area for a while, and my great leadership team around me, we've had some really good conversations. And what I've found success in is in this time, making sure that my leadership team and my kind of key leaders know I'm accessible, I'm available. Pull me in to where I can bring value and where I can remove roadblocks, where I can help you. And they're finding great freedom in that, to identify spaces where in this remote world, we started running into things just taking a little bit longer because there was so much distribution and so many different channels that things had to roll in. And so those are some areas that I found giving them the freedom to just pull me in as needed and help solve problems a little faster, help move things along a little quicker. And so that really comes down to great communication, right? It's clearly communicating expectations, clearly communicating what I'd like to be involved with, things that I give you freedom to just run on your own. And so a heightened level of clarity of communication, I would say, has probably been the most critical in purely going remote.
Yeah, it is a difficulty. It is a difficulty when you can't just kind of walk around the corner and get a sense and get a vibe and, you know, just kind of feel, you know, how a team or how people are doing. That's so hard. You know, I can remember when I ran teams remotely, you know, sometimes I would have a Zoom room like this just open for like, you know, 2 hours. I would just keep it open. And, you know, people would pop in and out, and it would be a way to try to connect with people. But it's still not the same. But you have to be super intentional. And I heard you say that as well. That's a big one.
Yeah, intentionality is a right word. I mean, my rhythms, you and I have some very similarities in how we're wired, is that finding rhythms that work, and they just become like clockwork. My rhythms have been just blown up. And so part of me is giving myself the space and freedom to be okay with what used to work doesn't work anymore, and just recognizing that, and then creating that space of freedom to, okay, I'm gonna try new things, and I've gotta find those new rhythms that work. And then also recognize is that, and you know this better than anyone as being a great leader, is that what's working for me isn't going to work for everybody else. And so I can't apply a default template of like, this is what I found works, go do it, because that's not going to be, you know, the template that's just going to solve everybody's problems. And so that goes back to that open communication, recognizing all of my leaders are wrestling with this in one way, shape, or form. I'm very fortunate. I don't have a lot of little kids running around. My kids are much older, and I'll have to navigate that. But many of my leaders have really young families. And so their worlds have been rocked in ways that mine haven't. And so having grace for that and recognizing their situations look a little bit different than mine.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we could have multiple discussions around how to lead with all of these challenges, just that alone. We don't have time for that, and that's not the purpose of this. But you know, Terry, to wrap this up, for anyone that's watching that wants to learn more about YouVersion, if they don't know what that is, or the Open Network, if there's churches that are inspired and need a platform, or just maybe need some resources of how to do it or how to do it better, where do they find that?
Yeah, absolutely. So if you're a church, pastor, leader, anywhere in that space, right now, just go to open.life.church. That is the front door of all of the free resources that we make available to churches all over the world. And so we have teams of people that wake up every single day trying to resource pastors and church leaders. And this platform is just one that we do. And it's a great tool right now, but there are so many ministry resources there. So number one, go there. If you are searching for a Bible app and YouVersion might not be it, but you have this little brown icon on your, you know, on your iPhone or Android that has a Holy Bible on it, that is YouVersion. Open up your app store if you don't have it and just type Bible. Will be your number one. Will be your number one choice there. And that is just, again, an up and to the right. In the midst of chaos, in the midst of all the craziness around us with people just struggling in many different ways, what we know as believers from that standpoint is that there is one true answer. And the Bible has that answer, and it's Jesus Christ. And so so that gives us a lot of hope and salvation there. And so the Bible's a great way to get engaged there. So you can search for that at your app store.
I was muted, so that's a bingo card for those, on Zoom calls. Hey, I was muted, sorry. Yeah. Great resources, Terry. I so appreciate it. Wish you and your teams the best as you get through this. I've been praying for you, and I'm glad that we can do that together, just as brothers. But seriously, keep up the great work. So many are relying on you and your teams, and I know that you're leading those teams in super intentional ways to be a true servant. because that's the heart of you and your teams, and which is amazing. So I love that. So I wish you the best of luck with that. I hope this can end up helping some other teams as well. And you and I will talk very, very soon.
Yes. Thanks, bro. Appreciate you.
All right. Talk to you later. Love you.
See ya.
See ya.
Love you too.